What's up, beautiful people, and welcome to another episode of Don't Keep Up With, Don't Keep Up With Us. Joneses. Don't Keep Up With Us, Don't Keep Up With Us. Joneses. Don't Keep Up With, Don't Keep Up With Us. Joneses. Don't Keep Up With Us, Don't Keep Up With Us. Joneses. Boom! What's up, beautiful people? It's me, Ricky Jones Jr. with 5 tips on how to embrace change as an expat here in South Africa. And I'm also gonna walk these streets of Sandton and show y'all the beauty of the architecture that is out here that you can experience if you do make a trip, visit, or make the move here. Now, I just happen to be like right in front of the one of the most beautiful buildings out here, right? But I'm gonna show y'all some other architecture and even some that one of the viewers' husband was a part of the crafting and building thereof. However, let's explore Sandton and let's talk as we do so. Now, one of the first things is to think outside the box. A tip to embrace the change that you will experience here is to think outside the box. Speaking of think outside the box, like, look at this, like, marble with like the black windows. Situation is a vibe, like it's a vibe. However, think outside the box. Why is that number one? Largely because whether you know it or not, you've been programmed, you've been taught, you've been trained, you've been conditioned. And when I say you, I'm talking about me too, to be able to live within the area that you are either raised in, you're born from, or that you have visited thus far, right? There are certain things that just work in the States that won't work here. There are certain things that work here or wherever country you may have been born in, raised in, or have come from or will come from to South Africa, that will just not work here. And so thinking outside the box is so necessary, so key, because, you know, we've been conditioned through television, through books, magazines, cartoons, the news. We've been conditioned to think thoughts and have ways of thinking that were best at that time. However, when you are in an expat or you're in another country experiencing something different, experiencing something new, then what you did there will not always translate or work here. Example, right? Thinking outside the box. I had to think outside the box as it pertains to like forms of payment, which we talked about it before. Here is very big on like EFTs or like deposits straight from your accounts. Whereas in like the States, you can control those things, or maybe I'm gonna pay card for this, or maybe I'll pay cash for that. Well, not always is that the case or the availability. And even it's amazing how in one setting or one space or country or whatever, cash may be king. But here, it's a lot of places that either don't accept cash or EFTs is the way to pay for schools or housing or whatever, whatnot. Like, that's a thing. But then as well, thinking outside the box has me with the understanding that, man, what I thought I knew or what I was told about a thing really isn't it. To give you an example, look at this building. This is the EY building, the Ernest and Young building, or I think that's what the E stands for, Ernest Young. It's a company actually that employs people all around the world, but this architecture is immaculate, right? And with that, I point that out, I show that because who would have thought? I didn't think that such beauty of architecture and feats like this would be here. Like, and what's crazy, let me show y'all, tell y'all this as well. I was hanging out with the kids. We was like walking outside and just, you know, living life as we do. And the kids was like laughing. And I was like, why y'all laughing? They was like, we finally saw a squirrel. Well, no, not a squirrel, a lizard. They finally saw a lizard that was just like walking on the sidewalk. And they laughed because it was something that we are accustomed to seeing in Florida, galore. But we just laughed about it because a thought is that there's roaming animals, terrible thought, but I'm gonna share it. But that's why we're thinking outside the box. But there are just roaming animals or whatever, whatnot, just out here living, doing their life. But truth be told, we haven't seen not a single, right, on that respect. But then even beyond that, we're even used to in the States having squirrels, right? We haven't seen a single squirrel out here in these streets. We were laughing and happy to see a lizard. It brought us some form of safety, like, okay, maybe we weren't tripping in the fact of the matter. But then I was talking to some other South African brothers and sisters, and they were sharing how, like, no, we don't have them animals like that, or mountain lions or something. And I was like, yeah, we got deer. My parents have deer in their backyard. It was like, deer? I was like, yeah, they'll look at you crazy if you, you know what I'm saying, step out where they are. And they was like, nah, we don't have it. I said, I know. I realized we don't even see squirrels. So again, think outside the box. Allow for yourself to experience where you are, wherever you are, no matter where you have come from. Because what you have had as far as experience, information, or knowledge until then has been useful for where you are. However, when you embrace what's here or embrace wherever country you may find yourself an expat in, you'll be able to experience what is there. What is life like there? What is the normalcy there? How are things done and conducted there? So you can get the best out of your experience and not be frustrated or feeling like, you know, homesick or whatnot because of what you're not getting as far as what you're used to. But again, let me show y'all this Ernest & Young building, like immaculately impeccable. Like, oh my gosh, I know I went fast on that thing. Let me come back down slow on that thing. But yeah, just right here in the city center of Sandton, in the midst of all the hustle and bustle and things like that. Like, this is what you can expect. This is what you can expect to see. But let's continue. So thinking outside the box could be a whole conversation by itself, but just to continue on this video and not to hold y'all too long, is one thing, the second thing that I learned to do that has been very helpful for me while being here is to put myself in other people's shoes. Now, specifically, talking of those that are here, like just giving me the perspective and the idea of like, all right, this is done a certain way, or these foods are eaten a certain way, or the customs, traditions, and cultures is a certain way that maybe I'm not used to or accustomed to, or in some cases agree with. However, I had to put myself in other people's shoes so that I could have the respect and understanding as to their why, as to their reasoning to why things are done that way. And again, I start from the very beginning by saying we are taught and conditioned to live life in a way that allows for us to survive and overcome the conditions in which we are lived in. Like, not often are people taught and trained to live life beyond what's the norm for them or beyond where they live or on an international scope or landscape, because I mean, that would have you to think on a broad scale, because things are done all around the world quite differently. Like, oh, let me just even push this button across the street. Didn't even know that was here. But anyway, anyhow, you have to put yourself in other people's shoes. Like, and that has been very helpful. Like, as y'all know, we had, or not we, but I had the little situation run in with the police or whatnot. Obviously not complaining about it, but in order for me to get over the situation, I had to put myself in other people's shoes, realizing, as people have expressed in the comment section, that there is a high crime rate of others, right, that are the color of my skin. And so to crack down on such happenings as that, the police have been, you know, given the fortitude or the leeway to do the search as they did to me. And okay, cool, you want to stop crime? I'm not a criminal. Ultimately, I have nothing to worry about. It was just the way it was done that was just throwing me off. But again, putting myself in the shoes of my brothers and sisters here, I recognize and realize that, all right, it's an issue. And when you have issues going on in your country or your area, you want the problem to be solved. And you're willing to do what is you believe is necessary to get the job done. So again, put yourself in other people's shoes. Or another scenario where I had to do so is when we were in an Uber car before and the gentleman didn't really speak English. And I had to realize that I'm in another country and English may not be the language that everybody can speak, even though it's a language that I only can speak. And so he was trying to work things out. And I was like, brother, it's okay. Like, it's all good. He kept saying, I apologize for my English. It's not good. It's not good. And all I could say is, bro, I get it. All is well. I have an idea of what you're saying. You're pointing me in the directions and things and showing me things as I'm asking. So all is well. Like, we good to go. But again, putting myself in his shoes, I didn't want him to feel no type of way or lesser than or anything like that. And so, you know, made him feel comfortable in the vehicle, but then of course gave him that a nice tip to say you did your job the way you needed to, even though I was asking above and beyond with the various questions and whatnot that I had going on. But oh, look at the entrance to the building. Like, it's the entrance to the EY building, Ernest & Young, I believe. But anyway, that is a tip that I believe is going to help a lot of people bridge the gap a lot quicker. Right, if you put yourself in other people's shoes, even if it's like, okay, let me feel how he would feel, empathize, let me feel how he would feel, or put yourself in their shoes, thinking about you being a foreigner in their company, in their country. Like, there's that whole situation dynamic. So that's a way to bridge the gap, right? Because y'all know we like peace. Speaking of peace, this building right here, game changer. Look at this. We're gonna walk to it, but I gotta show y'all the view that I have, like, of this. And right here, it's a train station in Houtang, I believe it's called, train station, that'll take you all the way to the airport and whatnot. But it's the Sandton stop. And even showing you the train situation and scenario, which I'm coming up on these trees that I absolutely love. Tip number three, as you out here exploring, living the expat life, like, I love these trunks, these green trunks, impeccable, is to explore your city, your new area, your new country, wherever you are, at the convenience and safety of yourself, right? Largely because you are new, coming into what is new, and obviously you may want to do all the various fun things, cool things that that city or that country has to offer. However, it's all about your safety. It's all about, and I'm gonna take a seat because there's a lot happening in front of me, and I just want that to be, you know what I'm saying, a little lower. But nonetheless, it's all about your safety. It's all about your comfort to be able to see things, experience things, do things the way you may want to. Maybe it's going and trying different foods. Maybe it's going exploring the malls, the zoos, safaris here in South Africa, or go explore the cultures that may be available, right? Like, it's a lot of things that you can do specifically here in South Africa, but I'm saying all that to say, do it in a way that's comfortable for you. I know, like, me and food, it's not really like a thing. So me trying all the different foods that a lot of my South African brothers and sisters try and eat, I probably won't, but it's okay, right? It's okay, because other people will. They'll showcase it, they'll share it, and they'll be able to tell others about it. And then I had a brother reach out to me because there's this opportunity that you have to walk with the lions. And he was like, oh, you need to try it. My brother Jabulani. Y'all check out his YouTube channel too. He's soon to move here, so make sure y'all show him love. And he was like, man, you need to walk with the lions. I said, man, I'm glad you did it and was able to share with me how it was. But speaking of how it was, let me show y'all these buildings, right? Because it's not all about what I have to say, but it's about this beauty of architecture that is out here. That's the Radisson blue, you know what I'm saying? Just showing y'all what's going on. Again, at this intersection where the Houtang, y'all, you know, you can let me know. Houtang, all that, bang, bang, walla, walla, bing, bang, that train station is. But yeah, I was telling him, like, shouts out to you, my brother. They don't have that push button at this light. But anyway, I was telling him, man, shouts out to you for doing that, but then as well having the story after that, because that's nothing I would do. Like, though I would skydive. But anyway, and even with that, there's even bungee jumping as a way to at the towers. Like, if that's something that you're interested in, do it when you feel safe. Like, all that to say, I've learned not to feel pressure to do anything, right? Don't feel pressure to do anything to fit in, or feel pressure to do things like at a rapid pace, because obviously we was once visitors, now we live here. So now the thought is, I gotta do this, or I gotta do that, or I gotta make sure I see this, or make sure I see that. But at the same time, I live here now, so I don't have to rush or anything like that to be able to see anything. Like, I live here, I'll see it, I'll get to it when I get to it. And that was like a peace of mind that I had and have now, in that we live here, right? Not to feel rushed to do anything, but to do everything when I'm comfortable, when I feel safe, or when I feel ready to do so, and we'll be good to go, just like that. But here we are, walking outside the Radisson Blue in this beautiful building that my brother Safiso, Old Mutual, is the name of this building that's to my left. Wait, let me show y'all. Boom, this thing is beautiful. It's a beautiful, like, green building with so many parts and pieces to it. I'm gonna find myself walking on that side, so y'all gonna see more of it. However, in it all, with it all, explore. We all explore, we're all excited, we all ready for it, but do it at your level of comfort and within your parameters of safety for you and how you live life, right? Like, don't just be out here exploring the new, just jumping deep into the new, doing things that you would never do even back at your home state, right? Because I don't know, and I don't want you to find out any negative effects of it, though there could be a lot of positives that will come along with it. However, in it all, with it all, we're gonna go to number four. And as I walk back up to where all the action is, number four, ladies and gentlemen, is to meet with other expats in your country, in South Africa, as well as locals, okay? But I'm gonna break it down first with the expats. Meeting with other expats groups and things like that will allow for you to, you know, have that comfort. It's that immediate comfort of the normalcy of what you may be accustomed to or used to from back in your country where you came from, or like myself from the States. That was one of the first things I did, was connected with other African Americans that are living out here. Largely because we all air quotes, right, have similar interests, like, oh, have you tried this food, or oh, where is this item, or oh, I was looking for that, or oh, do you have recommendations for fill in the blank? And we can all like network with each other and help one another out to get our feet on the ground and have that comfort that we are desiring and looking for within the new territory, the new country that you find yourself in. And as well, with us having kids, that was so awesome for us. Like, let me show y'all this building again. I believe Old Mutual is like one of the dopest buildings out here in Sandton. Like, it has three parts that I won't be able to show all from the ground. Like, some of you just have to drive up to see. However, with the expat community, with kids, it gives you the opportunity for the kids to play with other kids immediately and have similar interests of, or similarities of, being American, living in another country, used to certain things, talk a certain way, have like the same kind of like inside jokes, because you realize your slang is unique to your country. Maybe your inside jokes or the way you think about things are unique to your country. We've come here at, which it's fun, hearing the kids like pick up the different terminology and words that are used here in South Africa that we weren't using in the States, like yo and hi-bo and shame, and you know, we could do a whole video on that. However, with the all in it all, having that expat community will allow for you to feel that sense of home, even in your new home, your new space and place of residency. So highly recommend that as a tip for the expat community. And then even with it, having friends and those that you can talk to and associate with that, you know, are local here, very useful. Like, I love the communities, which I'm in a couple of them, three to be exact, but I love the communities where there's a mix of expats and locals, largely because like it's amazing how similar we are, right? And you know, I say it's amazing because one would make you believe that we're not as similar as we actually are, but we really are as a people. And when you connect in groups like that, you're able to see that, you're able to experience it, and you're able to recognize it for what it is. And it's a beautiful thing. Speaking of a beautiful thing, let me show y'all this building. So boom, here's the other side, or another side of it, which again, amazing. Like, amazing, the architecture. And it's something going on right here. Like, this is a parking garage for what's about to be a phenomenal structure, I'm sure, because that's all they do out here in South Africa. But anyway, when you bring together the expat community and the local community, we realize how similar we are, and we are able to bounce ideas off each other, and as well get a deeper understanding about life, right? We're able to come together, share our thoughts, and then find out what are the thoughts and what have been the thoughts here in South Africa, and why is this happening this way, and why that is happening that way. And we're able to have dialogue and conversations that are fruitful, not only for us as expats, but then I believe as well for my South African brothers and sisters that we come in contact with, largely because a lot of our content, our music, our culture has been received here, has been seen here, from The Cosby Show to Fresh Prince of Bel-Air to Family Matters to our music, to our dress and clothing. Like, it's all been experienced here in some way, shape, form, or fashion. And so being able to like have conversations to share, like, no, life isn't like that everywhere in the States, and not all people of color are living life that way as it's portrayed on television. Like, that's a good show with good ratings, with good script writers, right? And a great set. That's not normalcy or life in the norm in the state. So, you know, being able just to have those forms of dialogue and things have been very fruitful and eye-opening, because you realize that oftentimes people's view of the states is limited to what is seen by way of television, movies, music videos, for that matter, commercials, or what's popular on social media, as opposed to the real deal Holyfield, as some would say, that people are living their everyday lives, their 9-to-5 lives, scraping, figuring it out, trying to come up with what's necessary and best for their family. And then we realize how uniform we are in that respect, and then gaining a better unity, if you will, with each other. But let me show y'all this building, another one. Look at this. This is Chinese Bank of Communications and something else. But it's like a razor type situation. Like, it's a whole vibe, y'all. Whole biggity biggity vibe right outside of Mandela Square. But dope. I wasn't planning on walking into Mandela Square, but we find ourselves right here at it. So we'll see what happens. Just to give y'all perspective, like, all within Sandton. I'm still within Sandton. Haven't even walked back to where I parked before coming. But anyway, we can go to number 5 at this point, right? Yeah, I think we there. Alrighty, great people. Last but not least, number 5, as I walk into Mandela Square, I'm doing it for y'all. I'm showing y'all all of this. So when you come, you'll be excited because you know where you're going and you know what you're seeing. However, number 5, ladies and gentlemen, is to have someone that you can trust, reach out to, and, you know, in a way, depend on, that was born and raised in the country that you may find yourself in. Like myself, specifically, here in South Africa, I have a couple of friends that I could say I can reach out to in a moment's notice and ask them a question about this, or ask them a question about that, or get a point of reference for question about certain things. And I mean, they know, because they... All right, so I had to come up here because it was a lot of walking and situation happening. But nonetheless, in it all, it's been a very great asset to have, and highly recommended as a tip for you to have as well. Because when things have come up, when I've had questions about what's this or what's that or what's going on, or should this be the case or should that be the case, and I've been able to reach out to them and ask them that question specifically, and I've been given the answer, right, from numerous things. And one example is as it pertains to like the car buying process. As I shared with you all, we had to buy the car outright, which makes sense because we didn't have credit here. Therefore, we couldn't finance a vehicle here. However, I did find out all vehicles have the capabilities and ability to be, if you will, talked down as far as the price, right? We were told the price is what the price is, but let me show y'all the square. However, come to find out, there's always some negotiation room. Like, initially it's not going to be wanted, and as I was told, with the accent that I have and the fact that I'm paying cash, the thought isn't always, oh no, let me give you a discount. And so that's why we walked off that way. But he was like, if you buying a car, another car, let me know, and I can go out there with you during the negotiation process. And I was like, say less. And so things like that are things that we came to realize and recognize as a useful commodity, a useful ability, and useful for us to be able to have. And that's why, you know what I'm saying, you need somebody with understanding of the ways, the cultures, what is, what isn't, and what you can look to expect, to experience, and to see out here in your newfound country, territory, or land. There's the Mandela, boom shakalaka, all the way down to the plaque. And then you have the mini one like there. It's fun times, good times. But yeah, man, make sure you have somebody that you can trust, you can bounce ideas and thoughts off of, and you can get the comfort that you may be looking for that you have yet to receive because you just don't know. Or you may ask your brother, your sister that's, you know, local and born and raised here, what about this area? What about that area? Should I move here? Should I live there? Like, yes, it's good to have that expat brother and sister. However, when you have that one that has been here, they know the shifts, they know what has happened, and they know what you potentially or possibly could avoid in certain situations and circumstances. And so I say all that to say, I've come to realize having that person that's from here, that lives here, one of the greatest blessings that we've had and received. But then as well, you get invited to their homes and to their safe spaces and get to experience the culture and the people in a more intimate setting. Because of course, anytime you get invited to someone's home, it's far more intimate than going out to eat or meeting up at a coffee shop or whatnot. But that's that experience that you get when you find somebody that you can trust and depend on. And so that's why that's added to the list. And of course, y'all know I love to give a bonus, but I'm gonna wait till I get to the How Train area to give y'all that bonus. Haha. All right, so here is the How Train Sandton stop and station right there, boom shakalaka. You will go down there to your train and your ultimate destination. I'm not gonna lie, y'all, I love doing these videos walking around and watching people's reaction of me and to me as they see me recording. However, I did that as the tip going past the How Train station, largely because, like, to come out here, to visit out here, to experience what is here, to become an expat here, I would say take the trip, right? It's a trip one that you can do. It's a trip two that you should do. And coming here, you'll have the ability to not only experience a train ride if that's what you want to do, experience a plane ride because that's what you have to do to get here, but no, it's a trip worth taking. It's experience worth having. It's something that you'll always have that no one will be able to take from you. But I believe out of all of it, it'll be a realization of what is really going on around the world. I know for us as a Jones family, South Africa is the first place that we've lived in outside of the States. And prior to doing so, I never would have imagined that we would be living here. Like, never thought it. Not of anything wrong or bad or anything like that, negative, but just a simple thought, like, South Africa, like, I've been here, visited here, done missions here, but living here, again, never would have phantomed or imagined. But it was something that, one, we're able to do, two, something you're able to do. And with the trip here, you'll be able to see that this beauty that is all around me, the tips that I share with you, you'll recognize and realize it'd be, one, easy for you to do, two, you'll be excited to do it. But then thirdly, most importantly, when you intermingle with the people that are here, that have been raised here, born here, and live life here, you'll realize of how small the world really is, as far as like things that we're fighting for, things that we're desiring and wanting for our families as a whole, right? But then you realize just how precious and beauty life truly is because of how unified we are in the various spaces and places around the world. And so all that to say, great people, I love being an expat here in South Africa. I love the people here. I love the experiences that we get to have, those that we get to share on the channel. And more importantly, I love those in advance that you'll get the ability to take part in if and when you make this your home or visit the place called here, right? Johannesburg, South Africa to be exact. But y'all know I like to end in prayer, so let me cross the street and do so. So I'm actually gonna walk up on the front entrance to the Sandton City Mall. I'm gonna show y'all that as well. So maybe I should just pray out there. Yeah, let me do that. Yeah, yeah. So here we are, ladies and gentlemen, at the entrance of, yeah, Sandton City Mall. I had to make sure it said it out there. But anyhow, anyway, I'm gonna pray by saying, I thank you, Lord God, for this opportunity that I have had the time and the ears and the eyes of your precious sheep. I thank you, Lord God, for those that are considering of making the move of being an expat here in South Africa for a smooth landing, a smooth transition. They'll have the comfort, the wherewithal, the information, the knowledge, and the peace to not only make the move, but to thrive in their new space, their new country of living in. I thank you for my South African brothers and sisters that will embrace those that are coming in as expats, coming in, experiencing the new. And I thank you for the unity of us as people, right? Being able to learn new cultures and ways of doing things in a new space, in a new place, but as well mixing and mingling so that we will all have a global perspective of how we as people around the world are more common than we are different. So I thank you for this opportunity. I thank you for every opportunity that we have on each and every video. And I look forward to the fruits of comfort, of peace, of joy, and of unity amongst people around the world as people are realizing they can live a little bit of anywhere and have a good time. So as I make it back to my place called home, I thank you for whatever people call home, that it would be a great fun time and space of joy and fun. And so fun times, good times, all the same. And until next time, great people. Oh, in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. I forgot that part. See, man, when you cross the street, you start considering what's going on and what should be and where you are in perspective of everything. But anyhow, anyway, great people, going back to my vehicle, I am. And yeah, this was fun. This was fun. Y'all let me know where I should go next. Where would you want to see a walking video? Hey, I know Melrose Arch has been said, but y'all let me know in the comment section below, where should I walk next? And we'll see if it'll make it on a video as a vlog and whatnot. But until next time, great people, I love you all. I appreciate you all. Peace.